Already we discussed what is normal copy B is equal to A, and we discussed shallow copy, and now we are discussing deep copy. For deep copy, I am giving the command B is equal to A dot copy. So our first problem is A and B are having same addresses when B is equal to A. Now the problem one is solved. Why? Because when we give the command B is equal to A dot copy, then addresses of B and A are different. So definitely we can say these are two different arrays. Now in shallow copy, second, what is our second problem? The two arrays are interdependent. When we are changing the value in one array, the second array value is also being changed. But when we give a dot copy command, this will not happen. We are calling this as a deep copy. Now I am changing the value in array 100. The first index value I am changing to 100. If whatever I have said is correct, then the values of B should not be changed. We are executing this program. Yes, that is what really happened. In the first line, you can observe this is the address of A, 528. And this is the address of B, some 048. Two different addresses are created. Fine. Now, I have changed the value in A, 200. This is not affected the values in B. So this copying process is called as a deep copy. So we are revising. When we are saying B is equal to A here, it simply copies the B. We are thinking it is copying and two different arrays are creating, but in reality those two A and B variables are tagging to the same values in the same address location. So these are not two different. When we give A dot view, then there is no doubt two different arrays are created. But the problem is these two arrays are interdependent. If we change one array, the second array is being affected. If we do not want one array to be If we do not want B to be affected when we change the values of A, then we have to copy by using a deep copy technique. Then we are using A dot copy. This is how we can copy elements from one array to another array in different ways.